In this video, I will try to speak about my favorite albums of the 30, my favorite albums of the decade from 2010 until 2019. And it was difficult to decide which albums exactly I will put in this list, because in the beginning I said let's speak about 100 albums or about 50 albums. At last I said myself let's speak about 30 albums, and this is enough. So for this reason, some albums there I didn't put them inside my list. Unfortunately, this is also a video I made it one day afterwards that we listened, that unfortunately Neil Peart, the drummer of Russ, the Canadian progressive rock metal band, is dead. So rest in peace, Neil Peart. And here I have for me the most favorite albums of Russ. For me is of course 2112. Moving Pictures, Hemispheres, and at last and not least, Fly By Night. Okay, rest in peace, Neil Peart. And now, let's go to speak about the 30 albums of the decade in my taste, in my list. So, here I will speak about the albums with no special order, okay? How it comes? Okay. First, I will speak about one of the best thrash metal albums of the decade. I'm speaking about Overkill and their album Ironbound of 2010. With this album, Overkill came back to their old style. Let's remember, Overkill, they continued to make albums all these years that of the 90s, that the metal was and the thrash metal especially by some people they thought that it was dead, and Overkill and also Tankard from Germany continued to play this style of music, but with Ironbound they came back to their classical sound. Another also album that it was a comeback for the band, a very good comeback. I'm speaking about the band from England, Brother of Filth, and the album Hammer of the Witches of 2015. A very good album for the Brother of Filth. Another band from thrash and crossover metal, I'm speaking about the band Doctor Living Dead and their album Crush the Sublime Gods of 2015. And now a band that is not metal, is post-punk, their style, from England, if I'm not sure, and it's a band of all-female band. The band Savages, and they until now they made the two albums inside the decade. This is their debut album of 2013, Silence Yourself. A very good album with influences by Joy Division. Next comes a very good band from Greece. They play a style of thrash speed metal. They have influences by Motorhead, they have influences by Kill 'Em All of Metallica, and they speak about the band Demolition Train and the album Unleashed the Hordes of 2014. A very, very, very good album. And let's find there, inside this decade, there were many Greek thrash metal bands, new thrash metal bands. For example, you have to find Chaosphere, Speedrush, Nightbreed. There are many names that are coming from Greece, from the thrash scene. Okay, another also very good band from United States of epic metal or of US power metal. I'm speaking about the band Warlord, and this very, very good album the Holy Empire of 2013. Now, another band that I like it very much, Dark Throne from Norway, and the album Arctic Thunder of 2016. In this album, they were even more influenced by classical heavy metal. A very, very good album of Dark Throne. And now a band of style of sludge metal. And I'm speaking about Kilesa, and this is their last album, Exalting Fire, and if I'm not sure, this is the last album of 2015. A very, very good also band, very, very good album for me. Next, the last album of Primordial from Ireland, and their album of 2018, Exile Amongst the Ruins. Here also I could put also one of the albums of Atlantean Context from Germany. They are also a very good style of epic doom metal. Now, afterwards, here is the most important thrash metal band of the decade. I'm speaking about Verto, about Vector, and their second album, Outer Isolation, is a very, very, very good album of them of 2012. And afterwards they had another also album, and today we don't know what will become with Vector. And now, another album that people, I think that is even more epic metal, less black metal, but they have also influences by black metal. And of course I'm speaking about Demonaz of Immortal, that he made an album by his name, March of the North. This is the album of 2011, a very, very good epic metal album with black metal influences of Immortal. And for me comes now the one of the best black metal albums of the decade. I'm speaking about Vatain and their album of 2010, Lawless Darkness, from Sweden, Vatain from Sweden. Now, another album that is not metal at all, Arctic Monkeys from England, and their best album until now of 2013, AM. Next, one of the most favorite black metal album bands of Norway for me, Immortal, and their last album of 2018, Northern Chaos Gods, and it was also the first album without Abath, unfortunately, but it was even better than the two albums of Abath inside the decade. Here Immortal came back, and Demonaz especially, they came back to their roots. And now, a band that was very special, a very special band that started inside this decade. Until now they have three albums. And when they started, we didn't know how to put in to put them in which category we have to put them. They are from Norway, and they sing their songs in most of their songs not in English. In Norwegian, and they are not black metal, they're not rock and roll, they're not punk, they're all these things together. Speak about the debut album of Clevertak of 2013. And now an album that it was very close to my heart, I'm speaking about the album Dystopia of Megadeth of 2016. In this album Megadeth, they came back really, really to the roots. Yes, they made also very good albums in the last years. For me, the last favorite album of Megadeth before was the album Euthanasia. But afterwards, they made also good albums. The System Has Failed, for example, or United Abominations, or Endgame or 13, they were good albums, but with this album, Dystopia, they came back to the roots. This is an album that's very close to Rust in Peace for me. Another band from Greece, very good US power metal style band, that they are playing like Crips on Glory in their first days, like Hellstar. And I speak about the band Sacral Raids, and they have two albums inside this decade. This is the first debut album, Illusions in Infinity Void of 2015. And go and find them. If you like US power metal, go and find them now. Sacral Raids. Now, another band that I liked it so much, with the second album of 2018. For me, this was also the best album of 2018. And I'm speaking about Visigoth from United States, from Utah of United States, and their second album, Conqueror's Oath. Here we have influences by Grand Magus, by Manila Road, by Iron Maiden, with a very, very good way, Visigoth. And now, another also band that they are not exactly metal, they are even occult rock, but they made so much noise inside the metal scene. And they started with this decade, from the beginning of this decade until now. They have four albums, and I'm speaking about the band Ghost, and here I could put every album of them, but here I decided to speak about the first album, their debut album of 2010, Opus Eponymous. Another band from Sweden, with two albums until now inside the decade, with their debut album of 2013, Black Trip, and here are the two members of the band. They are also in Enforcer, in the album, in the band Enforcer, and their album Going Under, a very, very good album with Thin Lizzy influences. And now another also band from Germany, classical heavy metal band from Germany, with this album in the beginning of the decade, in 2010, with a new singer after that Udo left the band, and speak about Accept, they made a big change, a very good big change, and speak about the album Blood of the Nations of 2010, a very good heavy metal album. And if we're speaking about heavy metal, in 2018, Judas Priest, they came back with a masterpiece of heavy metal, and speaking about the album Firepower. And if we spoke about occult rock of Ghost, let's say that for me, the best occult rock until now, it was the band The Devil's Blood from Holland, and their second album of 2011, The Thousandfold Epicenter, a very good also album of The Devil's Blood. Another band that there are some people that will say then that they're metal, there are some people that they will say they're grunge. Let's think about Alice in Chains, and the album of 2013, The Devil Put Dinosaurs Here, a very, very good also album of Alice in Chains. And now another band, a new band in this decade, another new band, and I'm speaking about Midnight from United States, and they continue the way of Motorhead, Venom, Tank, Sodom, Toxic Holocaust, so they continue the same way of a style of rock and roll, thrash metal, speed metal, with black metal influences. I'm speaking about Midnight and their album, if I'm not sure, the second album, something like that, of 2011, Satanic Royalty, a very, very, very good album also of Midnight. And now I'm coming to a comeback album of the historical Swedish melodic death metal band At the Gates, and their comeback album At War with Reality, of 2014. Also a very, very good album for me of the decade. And now comes an album that many people, they think that this is the album of the decade. For me, it's not exactly the album of the decade, but one of the good albums of this decade. And I'm speaking about Behemoth and their album of 2014, The Satanist. Okay, Behemoth is something like a black metal band from Poland. Afterwards, they became even more technical death metal with influences by Nile. Afterwards, black and death metal. Here they're playing a style of black and death metal, of black and melodic death metal, let's say, but in very, very good way. Now another band from England that I like it so much. I'm speaking about Paradise Lost, and they're more or most heavy album of them after they came back, okay, after they come back. Speak about the album Medusa of 2017. This album was the most heaviest album of them in their new era. Even more heaviest than The Blank Within, or from even more heaviest from In Requiem. And it's also very close to albums as Gothic or as Saints of God. A very, very, very good album of Paradise Lost. Next, another album of heavy rock with metal influences. Okay, let's say and speak about the album The Oracle of Godsmack of 2010. Very, very, very good album also. And now I'm the last album of these 30 albums, also of 2010, speak about a band from England, a very special band. People, and they are saying that they are stoner, others they are saying they are doom. For me, they are a doom metal band with stoner influences. And speak about, of course, Electric Wizard and their album Black Masses of 2010. So this is was my list of the best 30 albums of the decade from 2010 until 2019. So from Israel and from Jerusalem, stay metal and stay heavy.